Wellington town at the sign of the plough. There lived a mole catcher, well I'll tell you now. Had a young wife who was buxom and gay, and she and another young farmer would play. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Well, the farmer he knocked on her door and did say, where is the mole catcher, good woman, I'll pray. Out catching moles, love, you need never fear. But she didn't know the mole catcher was near. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Well, he crept up the stairs in the midst of their ruckus. The mole catcher grabbed the young man by the tuckus. Said, I've been a mole catcher for most of me life, but you're the first mole that I've caught with me wife. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Well, I'll make you pay dearly for telling me ground. So out of your pockets I'll pull 20 pounds. 20 pounds, said the farmer, I really don't mind, for it only works out about tuppence a time. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie. Load laddie, load laddie, lie, load laddie.
There was Johnny McAldoo and McGee and me, and a couple, two or three, went on a spree one day. Had a bob or two, which we knew out to blue, when the beer and whiskey flew, and we all felt gay. Visited McCann's, McMillan's, Hopty Dan's, then went into Swan's, our stomachs far to pack. We ordered out to feed, which indeed we did need, and we finished it with speed, but we still felt slack. Johnny McAldoo turned as blue as a dew, and a plate of Irish stew he'd soon put out of sight. Hollered at in core with a roar for some more, said he never fed before such a keen appetite. Ordered eggs and ham, bread and jam, what to cram, but him we couldn't tram, though he tried a level best. For everything we brought, cold or hot, mattered not, it went down him like a shot, but he still stood the test. Or a tripe of lard, with the yard we get scarred, it would go right hard when the waiter brought the bill. Told him to give o'er, but he swore he could lower twice as much again and more before he had his fill. Nearly supped a trough full of broth, says McGruff, he'll devour a tablecloth if you don't haul him in. When the waiter brought the charge, McAldoo felt so large, he began a scolding barge, and his blood went afire. Began to curse and swear, tear his hair in despair. Finished the affair, called the shopman a liar. Shopman he drew out, and the doubt he did clout. McAldoo, he kicked about like an old football, tattered all his clothes, broke his nose, I suppose he would have killed him with a few blows in no time at all. McAldoo began to howl and to growl, by me soul, threw an empty bowl at the shopkeeper's head, struck poor Mickey Flynn, peeled the skin off his chin, and the ructions did begin, and we all fought and bled. Peelers did derive, man alive, four or five, and at us they made a drive for us all to march away. Paid for all the mates that we ate, set us straight, and went home to ruminate on the spree that day.